series. Number 8, Clemson against number 12, South Carolina. Hi again, everybody. I'm Jim Kelly, and welcome. A lot of emotion here. This is Mike Hogue, the student body president at South Carolina. This is your fourth game. You've won one, you've lost one, you've tied one. Why is this game so emotional?
There's 3 years of civil war in the state of South Carolina. For 3 hours of going at it, tonight will decide for the seniors the tiebreaker here in Carolina and the bright lights for the rest of our lives.
Any doubt in your mind who's going to win this game?
Carolina by 20, no doubt about it.
I think they agree with you here. Let's find out over on the Clemson side. Kevin?
Jim, there's plenty going on over here in the Clemson section. It's about 150 miles from Clemson to Columbia, South Carolina, and these people aren't a bit tired from the trip. With me is the president of Central Spirit of Clemson, Pat Quarles. Pat, what is Central Spirit?
We're a student organization that gets together about 150 people so we can come down to South Carolina and have a lot of fun.
Is this the biggest game of the year?
Excuse me?
Is this the biggest game of the year?
Oh, my God. We're going to blow them out.
I think it's clear that these Clemson Tiger fans can't wait to get their paws on South Carolina. Back to you, Jim.
Nothing else matters in the state of South Carolina. Not the governor's race, not that golf tournament at Hilton Head. This is the state's biggest spectacle. And it is number 8, Clemson, against number 12, South Carolina. The Tigers and the Gamecocks. Welcome back, everybody. You know, Kevin, when you think about it, I think the main reason that South Carolina's been able to pull even with Clemson, quarterback Todd Ellis, he's been the equalizer.
Well, he certainly has. He was a recruiting coup, but I think the strength of the offense and the key to the offense, Jim, are the skilled people. Sharp and Bethea and Harold Green, the running back. These are the guys that really take the pressure off the young quarterback. They're such good players, they make Ellis a better player.
All right, now, running the run and shoot, and with Todd Ellis, what kind of pressure, extra pressure, does that put on Clemson?
Well, it's a very aggressive offense by South Carolina, but Clemson has a very aggressive defense, and they'll have to play defense all over the field tonight. The run and shoot is a type of offense that reads the defense. They're going to throw the ball all over the field. They also run the option, so Clemson will have to make Ellis pull up, and they'll have to play tough, or they won't be in this game tonight, Jimmy.
Both teams are bowl bound. Here they come, the Clemson Tigers, head coach Danny Ford. They're 9-1, and they're headed to the Citrus Bowl. Also bowl bound, South Carolina. They're 7-2 for Coach Joe Morrison. They're about to come out of the tunnel, and what you're about to see is a spectacle unto itself. Let's enjoy. College football's great rivalries. It dates back to 1896. This is the 85th meeting with the Tigers of Clemson enjoying that 49-31 victory edge. There have been four ties, the last one last year. They were knotted up at 21 apiece. And as you see, South Carolina has not beaten the Tigers here since 1979. There are the Gamecocks. They will have to play very, very carefully on specialty teams, especially when the Clemson punt return and kick return teams are out there, Kevin.
Well, Wolford and Lott, respectively, are the third and fourth leading punt returners in the nation. Special teams could play a large part in this game. To kick off, the place kickers, Colin Mackey and David Treadwell, are tied in the nation for the most field goals. They both have 18. Treadwell, 18 for 21. Mackey, 18 for 25. So special teams, in what it figures to be a close game, should play a big part.
There is Rusty Sile, the junior out of Savannah, Georgia. He is 6'1", 182 pounds, and he will kick off for the Clemson Tigers. Back deep, Sterling Sharp, and he can fly. You can see he averages almost 29 yards per kickoff return. Also, Kevin Jones, who averages 28 yards per kickoff return. There he is, back deep for the Gamecocks. So we are underway, the 85th renewal, the Tigers and the Gamecocks. High, end over end, and Sharp at the 5. 15, 20, explodes to the 25, up near the 30. So as the Gamecock offense comes out, Kevin, let's meet them with quarterback Todd Ellis.
Just a sophomore, a record breaker already, a great one. Very few can run that run and shoot. Harold Green, well, a guy that maybe is a little unheralded, but a great running back. He scored 14 touchdowns. Sharp and White, Sharp's the All-American, as they say, a number one prospect at wing back. And the other two wideouts, very big, 6'3", both over 200 pounds. The offensive tackles, excellent players. A little small across the offensive line. Woody Myers, the surprise of the season so far at center.
Ryan Bethay lying up wide to the left. Motion across the back is Harold Green, 22. That's Kevin White in motion. Ellis will throw on first down. He's got White. And White up across the 30, up near the 36-yard line for a pickup of 7, 2nd and 3 coming up. Let's meet the Tiger defense.
Middle guard Tony Stevens, an All-ACC candidate. Michael Dean Perry, the refrigerator's little brother, and a great one. The outside backers are defensive end. Earl, also an all-conference candidate. Hatcher, a good player. Maribel, a little better against the run. Taylor, an excellent backer, too. Maybe a little slow. These guys are excellent. The strength of the secondary, the safeties, maybe a little suspect for Clemson.
Motion across by Sterling Sharp on 2nd and 3. Slot to the right with White and Bethay. Ellis airborne again. Got his man. Gamecocks with a first down. The 43-yard line. Sterling Sharp upended by Vince Taylor, the sophomore out of Clearwater, Florida.
Well, what you see there is the strength of the offense. Now, these guys, this is Sterling Sharp. He's going to go in motion, make them declare coverage. They'll have to shift. That lets Todd Ellis know exactly what they're going to do, and they're playing off the receiver. See Sharp, plenty of room. They throw it right out like they did on the first play. He'll pick up 6, 7, 8 yards. You have to cover these guys close, but I don't know that Clemson has the people to cover a man-to-man. It's going to be a problem.
Motion by Kevin White on 1st and 10 from the 43. Same play the other way. White's got it bumped out of bounds near the 46-yard line. You surprised that Joe Morrison is opening it up so quickly?
No, actually, he's not. That's like a running play, Jim. And what they're doing is they're trying. Clemson, historically, this year, likes to play their corners about 10 to 12 yards off. They knew that coming in, and they're going to make them come up. And as soon as they come up, they're going downtown with the ball. That's three straight plays, very, very similar.
The run and shoot. Joe Morrison ran the veer for so many years. Ellis now, 3 for 3, 18 yards. Looking for their next first down. Be number 2. McVay and White, wide to the right. Motion. And Sterling Sharp. Run and shoot will go the other way. Ellis, incomplete at the 45. Looking for Sharp on a curl in. Now, two freshman linebackers are in there now for Clemson. Doug Brewster, number 92 at the middle linebacker. And at the bandit spot out of LaGrange, Georgia, John Johnson, number 12.
And the reason they have those two guys in there, they play excellent pass defense. Brewster has started just 2 games, the past 2 games, last 2 for Clemson. Brewster was in there. They've had a little bit of trouble at the inside backer position. They've got a young guy in there, but he's done pretty well.
On 3rd and 6, Kevin, they don't blitz very often, but will they now?
Middle of the field, very tough to blitz this team because Ellis reads it so well.
Sharp in motion, top of your screen. Midfield, couldn't crack it.
Well, there's one thing they'd rather have from Ellis. It's a little more foot speed. He did not have the speed to get outside. Clemson put under pressure with a 3-man rush.
Ganell Wolford is back deep. 16 yards on his punt return. Rodney Price, not a good kick, but it gets a good bounce for the Gamecocks. Hits at the 17 and will be blown dead at the 9-yard line. 12:49 left to go. Let's meet the offense. Quarterback Rodney Williams.
Option quarterback that does not run that well, but passing, he's had his best two games, last two games of the year. Lancaster, they say, maybe the best blocker in the country at fullback, McFadden, an excellent young tailback. Receivers, Cooper, the leading receiver on the team, Jennings, 225-pound wideout. The tackles, Nunnemaker is an all-conference candidate. They're both big and excellent players. Back, and Phillips is an All-American candidate. Back having a good year.
Tigers open up with McFadden and Lancaster. The I-Pro set goes to the tailback, Wesley McFadden. Slithers to the 12 for a pickup of 3, 2nd down and 7. Here come the Gamecocks defensively.
Very quietly, Roy Hart, maybe the best middle guard in the country, having a big, big year. Outside linebackers or defensive end. Diggs started out slowly, playing better. These guys can both run, as can the middle linebackers. They stunt quite a bit. They don't take linemen on directly. Corners and secondary super players. Lloyd Robinson, great man-to-man pick from Phil Paul Edwards, as good as you'll find anywhere.
They've only got 8 running plays that they brought with them. They've used 2. Brendan McCormick, number 95, the senior out of Chicago, Illinois, hampered by injuries throughout his career. 6'6", 266 on the stop. Here it is.
Roy Hart, number 54. They're coming at him from all angles, as you do a middle guard. They get him out of the play, but you can see what happens. It frees up the other people, and they were able to get in and stop the Clemson team. Terry Allen out with a cracked rib. He will not play. They normally switch tailbacks. They cannot do that tonight. They had to start McFadden.
Rodney Williams, 79 completions, 164 attempts. Don't throw off on sideline. It is caught at the 26-yard line. A remarkable catch by Keith Jennings. Might have been picked off, an 18-yard reception. Kevin, that was a dangerous ball to throw.
That ball never should have been thrown. Virtually impossible to catch, but he caught it. Now here's Windsor on the outside. Number 20 coming up the seam. All over Williams. Williams panicked a little bit. Let's go of a lame duck. Coverage just not there. Now, they play a lot of man-to-man coverage, the South Carolina, and it was not close enough to Jennings. That bad pass got in there.
What do you think? If Robinson played the ball, he had the interception from the 27, 1st and 10. Penalty flag is down, and so is Lancaster. Roy Hart, the nose guard out of Tifton, Georgia, made the stop. And I think perhaps the tight end, Danny Perriman, moved number 89 against Clemson.
Jim, that pass was out of character, really, for Clemson. They're a very conservative offensive team to throw that deeply.
Illegal procedure on the offensive team.
To throw from that deeply in their own territory, it means that they feel they have to open up the offense early. They don't like to do that. Danny's always been a conservative coach.
Youngest man to win the national championship. There he is, Danny Ford. Did it back in 81 when he was 33 years of age. Bud Wilkinson won the national championship when he was 34 at Oklahoma back in 1950. Paul Brown at Ohio State when he was 35. And Paul Dietzel at LSU when he was 35. 1st and 15 after the penalty. The tailback. Nowhere. Wesley McFadden. 2nd and long coming up. Kurt Wilson, the sophomore out of Middlesex, New Jersey, on the stop.
Gamecocks have gone to a 50 alignment. Joe Lee Dunn, used to be head coach at the University of New Mexico, has changed the defense, a stunning defense. They will go straight man-to-man at the corners with a free safety to play an 8-man line. Very tough against an I-formation team, a team that wants to run the ball. It's going to be tough sledding for Clemson.
Cooper to the far side, Jennings to the near side, I-pro set, Lancaster, McFadden. Across the 35, bumped out of bounds by Brad Edwards.
Again, you've got an 8-man lineup here, and they're coming all the time. So basically, most of the time, 9 out of 10 plays, you've got a blitz situation. Williams knows it, he reads it. Jennings hooks up short, and he gets the ball to him. And had his knee not gone down there, he'd have gone down the road. Robert Robinson should not and cannot miss tackles out at the corner, especially playing man-to-man coverage.
Just shy of the 32-yard line. 3rd and 6 coming up. Rodney Williams takes a timeout. He looked over that Gamecock defense, and they'll send as many as 8 players at one time. He didn't like what he saw, so a timeout with 9:29 to go in the first quarter. The 85th battle between South Carolina and Clemson were scoreless. Well, if you were watching that exciting World Cup of Golf on ESPN earlier today, here's an update. Wales has defeated Scotland on the second hole of sudden death. Third and six. The fullback, nothing doing. Interesting play call.
Clemson is definitely limited in their offense. They run an option, but Williams is not a great runner. Has about 145 yards this year. So South Carolina, well coached, sitting on that fullback and probably the pitch man.
You surprised because Williams was 2 for 2? They picked up a couple of first downs.
Well, legitimately, he wasn't. That one pass never should have been thrown. As I told you, Clemson is a defensive team, and they are very, very conservative offensively.
Sterling Sharp. Have to put a net around him to slow him down. South Carolina will get a roughing the kicker call. The ball dead inside the 20, but the Tigers of Clemson come out in good shape. Ron Rathbun, number 15, I believe, was the first Gamecock to come through. A 47-yard punt, but this one will come back for Danny Ford.
There's no way this is roughing the kicker. This thing would have been blocked had they come through it. They all pulled up and spun away from the kicker. Watch this. And he just goes down. This is not even a good acting job. No way. I mean, that is absolutely no way there's a penalty on that. Ron Rathbun is the guy that they're calling on it, but it's just not a penalty.
And even if he did hit him, he was blocked into him by his own man.
There's no way. If he kept coming, he would have blocked that thing.
So it's a big first down for the Clemson Tigers. 8:39 left to go in a scoreless first quarter. The Gamecocks and Clemson knotted up, nothing, nothing. South Carolina slightly over a touchdown favorite. Shed Diggs, the senior out of Fort Myers, Florida. Of course, the defensive coordinator, reunited with head coach Joe Morrison, Joe Lee Dunn. Kevin talked about it, former head coach out of New Mexico.
A tremendous difference, point differential, absolutely incredible. From last year, they gave up about 199 points to this point in the year and less than 100 at the same point this year. What he did, he took his personnel, and instead of playing people straight up, he moved them around. They do a lot of stunning. It's made a world of difference.
Johnson, the lone running back. Jennings in motion. Goes to the big fullback. He knifes his way up near the 45 in the grasp of Roy Hart, senior out of Tifton, Georgia. How well have the Gamecocks improved? Well, in 86, you can see they allowed almost 180 yards against the rush, but in 87, with Joe Lee back, same thing against the pass, almost knifed in half, and total offense.
217 points to 84. Last two games, total shutout, about 100 yards in total offense they've given up in the last two games.
Johnson with a big hole right side. First down for the Tigers into Clemson territory. A 14-yard carry. Ken Sally and Brad Edwards on the stop.
Nice job by Harmon and back, and Phillips in the middle of that Clemson line on Roy Hart, number 54. If you can move this middle guard, and they do, they just bury him. Great block coming down. And off we go to the races. Number 71, Ty Granger coming down, making a great block on the tackle.
This is what Clemson wants to do. A long, sustained scoring drive. Eat up some time. Keep the ball away from Todd Ellis. Pitch back. McFadden goes the other way. Dives down. Maybe made it back to the line of scrimmage. Second and 10. Matt McKernan, the junior out of Daytona Beach, Florida. 6'2", 235 on the stop. Helped out by Derek Frazier.
These guys are very small across the front for South Carolina, but what they can do is run. And when you go wide on them, you find out they get way outside real quick like they did on that pitch, and they were able to stop McFadden. As you see, they have shut out North Carolina State and Wake Forest in the last two games. They have not been scored upon. Virtually no offense at all have they given up.
Off the screen, Gary Cooper. Meanwhile, Tracy Johnson hammers his way inside the 40. Close to the 44-yard line. That'll bring up third. Greg Philpott, the senior safety out of Largo, Florida, on the hit. And there is some hitting. They will hit you. Very tough down for Clemson. Their tight ends are not great receivers. Their tailback is not a good receiver. Normally, they have to go to their wide people on downs like this, and you can bet that South Carolina will be looking for that and coming hard with a blitz.
Clemson, 2 out of 3 on third down conversion. Williams, who was redshirted back in 84, checks the game count. On fake, looks over the middle. Man is wide open. First down at the 22-yard line. Keith Jennings. He had Norman Floyd beaten by 4 yards. A 17-yard pickup. First down, Tigers.
Well, I said they have to go to their wide people. He wanted to go one way. There was nothing there. But Williams, smart, goes the other way. And Jennings is a monster. 6'4", 225. And he has beaten Floyd by 5 yards. Pass is good enough. Jennings is big enough. He makes the catch.
And if that name and some of those moves are familiar, it should be. His brother, Stanford Jennings, plays for the Cincinnati Bengals. First and 10 at the 22. Out of the power eye, McFadden explodes inside the 20. Down at the 17-yard line in the grasp of the freshman out of Atlanta, Georgia, Patrick Hinton.
There's an advantage for Clemson on offense. It's that offensive line. They're very big and strong. They've been compared by the Gamecocks to Nebraska. Nebraska, a team that drove 96 yards late in the game, a 9.5-minute drive, just physically overpowered the Gamecocks. They're worried about that tonight against Clemson.
They could have used a couple of drives like that today. On 2nd and 6. At the 10-yard line, Williams pulled it down on the option play. Again, keep in mind, we talked about it, Kevin, only 8 or so running plays coming in for the Tigers. They do what they do well, very well.
Patrick Hinton, the linebacker, number 46, right side of your screen, coming up, not sure what he's looking at, gets pulled down and held. Williams able to cut up inside. Williams not a great runner. 57 carries, 145 yards for an option quarterback coming into this game. Those are not great numbers.
Chris Lancaster, 49, joins Tracy Johnson. Full house backfield. Lancaster in motion. Reverse spin. And Rodney Williams pulls it back down, dives down close to the 5. Hinton has him there.
Tigers are doing a real good job sealing the inside and giving them room to run up that off-tackle alley. And that'll happen a lot when you have a slanting defense that moves around a lot, like South Carolina. They're getting sealed off.
4:35 left to go in a scoreless first quarter. The Gamecocks are backed up. They've taken timeout. We will, too. Longhorns and the Aggies won today, so that showdown on ESPN on Thanksgiving night will be for the Cotton Bowl bid. I'll bring the turkey, you bring the stuffing. Join Kevin and I, 8 o'clock Eastern Time, live on ESPN. This Clemson drive has used up 8 minutes and 14 seconds so far. It's 2nd and 7 from the 7. Full house backfield again. Bumped out of bounds near the goal line. McFadden again. How about the quick acceleration? He was back at the 10-yard line. At about 2 steps, he was inside the 5.
Wesley McFadden was a backup defensive back in 1985. Moved from there 2 years later to a starting tailback. They've gone to 2 tights, Clemson. They're going to use that weight and strength advantage, and they're going to try and pump this one in.
Very close. What do you do? About a 0.5 yard for the touchdown.
Matt McKiernan coming up here from the linebacker position, diving in, piling it up, and the Gamecocks outweighed on that front line, able to turn it laterally, which is what you have to do before they get over the goal line, and they give Clemson a problem now. What to do?
Well, they'll take a timeout and talk about it with 4:06 left to go. Looked like they tried to get a play in, and there was a bit of confusion, so Rodney Williams, who was redshirted back in 84, will come over and chat with head coach Danny Ford.
Well, you talked about confusion. One of the things, Jim, that South Carolina's defense will do, Joe Lee Dunn, is put in a defense that never stays in the same place twice. They'll do a lot of stunning, and the one way to neutralize physical power is to move around and do different things, and then they hesitate. They don't know who to block. By the time the offensive lineman decides who to block, the defense is in on the ball carrier. On the goal line, sometimes it's more difficult to play that defense because everybody area blocks and they just blow you out. You only need a yard or two, and that's what Clemson has to decide here, whether or not
they are going to be able to blow these guys out. Of course, that's Joe Lee Dunn talking to his safety, Philpott, and they're going to determine what exactly they need to do. I think they've got to forsake the pass. I don't think Clemson will pass in this situation. I'd play 9-10-man line and go after defensively.
Don't forget, at the conclusion of this game, we'll be going out to beautiful Honolulu, Hawaii, for that whack battle between the Air Force Academy and the Rainbow Warriors of Hawaii. So be sure and stay tuned on ESPN. That game coming up next. But we've got a long way to go. This is the 18th play of this drive coming up. Again, they've used up almost 9 minutes. Out of the I-Pro set, Johnson and McFadden. Tight end Terman lines up now on the left side. Option McFadden, touchdown Tigers! And what a great job Rodney Williams did, Kevin. He waited until the last possible moment to release the trigger on that option. Almost looked like he'd get sacked.
Well, he didn't have a moment. That was the key, and you're right. He did not have a second. Watch how quickly Carolina forces him to pitch that thing. He never takes a step, never thinks about going. He gets the ball out to the tailback quickly enough to use his speed to turn it up, and a great job by Williams.
McFadden scores the touchdown. Treadwell, an outstanding place kicker, will increase the 10th Clemson advantage, but there's a flag to be checked out.
Dead ball foul. The linemen are moving on the offensive team.
It will still just be a chip shot for Treadwell. David Treadwell, the senior out of Jacksonville, Florida. 86 of 87 career extra points.
And he's never missed a field goal in the last 8 minutes of a game. 8 minutes and in, he's been perfect in his career. That's an incredible statistic.
You don't think he'll be somebody's high draft choice, do
you? He could go number one, I think.
Out of the hold of Morocco, the backup quarterback. This one's on its way, and it is up, and it is good. 4:02 left to go. The Tigers strike first. A long way to go. Gamecocks get the kickoff next.
Gamecocks had it defensed on the outside. See, they have three people. Now watch Hinton, number 46. He doesn't realize what he's looking at. He hesitates. By the time he realizes the play's going outside, he's lost two steps, and that's enough for McFadden. Here's the end of the play. Hinton just not able to get out there and make the play, and that's why he scored. When you're sitting outside against an option team, you've got to recognize it immediately. He didn't.
The sixth touchdown on the year for McFadden as Sale is about set to kick it off. It is high, it is end over end, and it is Sterling Sharp at the five. 20, 25, 26, and 27-yard line. A 22-yard kickoff return sets up the Gamecocks in pretty good field position as we check scores from earlier in the day. Kevin's old school, Wyoming, wins by 24. Stanford, no problem against California. Oregon, Oregon State, a mismatch there. And Don James and his Huskies rule over Washington State. BYU over Utah. Motion by Kevin White. For maybe 2 yards, second and eight coming up as we check that scoring drive. And Kevin, really two keys, 18 plays, they used up almost 9 minutes and they go 91 yards, very impressive, but helped out by that roughing the kicker call.
That was absolutely the difference in the drive, and when you have a small defense playing against a bigger offense and something like that happens to you, it's demoralizing and exhausting, exactly what South Carolina did not want to have happen in this game. Takes the crowd out, tires out their defense right away.
But exactly what Clemson did want to happen. Kevin White, motion near side. Reverse pivot, Todd Ellis, and it slithers right through the arms of Ryan Bethea. Bethea came in, 39 catches, 521 yards, averaging about 13 and a half yards per catch. Great size, good speed, catches in a crowd and across the middle. So that was very uncharacteristic.
Well, that ball was tipped, Jim, by Otis Moore, number 81. It was thrown laterally. They're lucky Moore didn't intercept it. He took a step into the backfield, put his arm out, and he tipped it.
Ellis, 3 out of 5, 18 yards, needs 7 right here. Sharp coming at you. Ellis, bumped out of bounds at the 26-yard line by John Johnson, the freshman out of LaGrange. Tigers are fired up on defense and doing a job, and it's a game, Kevin, of perimeters.
Yeah, and Clemson did a job with three people up front. Now, that's all. Look at the three people. That's all the pressure. They're dropping eight people and getting pressure with three. Look at the right corner of your screen. Ellis has no place to run, and that front three is getting to him with no help.
Rodney Price, another punt. They almost blocked it. This is a line drive that James Watt will get out of the way of. Takes another good bounce for the Gamecocks, blown dead at the 25-yard line. 2:57 left to go. A 49-yard kick, no return. Clemson's ball when we come back. Hi to Mom and Dad in Kenai, Alaska. Clemson 7, South Carolina nothing. 2:57 left to go in the first quarter. Rushing yardage, Clemson 47, South Carolina a minus one. Explodes to about the 28-yard line. Kurt Wilson, the sophomore from Middlesex, New Jersey, on the stop.
Gamecocks coming with a blitz on first down, as they will. And the reason they can do that, they've got the great defensive backs. They play that man-to-man.
Kevin, from a momentum standpoint, we'll go back to McFadden's touchdown. The Gamecocks have not allowed a touchdown in over eight quarters now. Will that take any oomph out of their defense?
Well, yeah, I think streaks help the defense momentum-wise if you think about not giving a touchdown.
Back, big hole right side. There goes Chris Lancaster. He's chased out at the 35-yard line. Should be enough for a first down for the Tigers. Robinson chased him out of bounds. Hole on the right side opened up by Phillips and Neunemacher.
Doing a job on number 54 Hart. That's Jeff Back. Getting some help from the side. Now Hart's got to get lower and do a better job. You've got to fight pressure and step into that or step around it. He's got to be able to hold his ground. If the middle guard gets moved out, you have no defense. And with this defense moving around behind him, there's going to be a lot of holes if he doesn't plug the middle.
They move the chains, Kevin, up to the 35 out of the Irish Pro set. It's a first down. Kevin Williams looks over the middle. Man is open. It's deflected, picked off. South Carolina, Patrick Hinton, the freshman out of Atlanta, inside Tiger territory at the 45. Hinton had two interceptions coming in. That's number three. He was redshirted last year.
Well, the receiver was open early, but he wasn't open when Williams throws this thing off his back foot, just lays it into the middle of the field. You see Hinton there. It looked like it was almost interference. That was Norman Floyd who tipped the ball, and Hinton turned around, just happened to be in the right place. That ball, as you see again, never should have been thrown. And that's that man-to-man coverage. Now, there's only three guys back there, and they do a great job of staying on the receivers. Hinton got the interception, but you give it to Floyd who made the tip.
All State out of Lakeshore High School in Atlanta. Patrick Hinton came up with his third interception. And a late flag.
Dead ball, personal foul on the black team, first and 25.
You know, penalties have hurt South Carolina, but it's Clemson, really, that has been terrible with penalties this year. They had 91 for 744 yards to this point in the year in 10 games. That's an average of 9 a game, and yet early in this game, South Carolina has been the one that's been guilty.
That was a huge penalty against South Carolina. They had the ball at the 45 of Clemson. They start from their own 40. They get five of them back. Trap on the right side to Harold Green. Blocking up front by Woody Myers, Paul Shivers, and Mark Pryor.
Tigers invite you to run. They set their linebackers about 5 yards deep. South Carolina knows that, but they play that single back offense. They don't have a lead blocker. You should be able to pick up 2-3 yards against Clemson up the middle with any kind of a block because of those linebackers sitting back there.
Second and 20. Loads, got his man, Sterling Sharp. Penalty flag is down in the secondary, and Sharp is upended at the 42-yard line. Vince Taylor, the sophomore out of Clearwater, Florida, on the stop, but there's a flag to be checked out. A 24-yard pickup, apparently. Let's see who the call goes against.
Defensive team holding five for the pass.
Crossing pattern by Sharp. I think they tried to hold up number two. Watch Vince Taylor. Number 58 for Clemson. Hitting him before the pass, getting a little bump on him and holding his shirt. They complete it anyway as Ellis, with great sense of where he is on the field, stepped up and completed the pass.
Out tell you what, if you can isolate Sterling Sharp all night on the linebackers, you're going to have a field day.
Well, they're dropping eight people, Jim, and they're trying to get pressure with three, and they're doing a good job of it. If Ellis hadn't taken a few quick steps, he never would have gotten that pass off. Not much room in that secondary.
Sterling Sharp in motion. Dive over the right side goes to Harold Green, the sophomore. And the middle guard, Tony Stevens, on the stop, the senior out of Walderboro, South Carolina.
Clemson defense, as I said, they'll sit those linebackers. See how far back? That's a 5 full yards off the line of scrimmage. It helps them avoid blocks. But what it does, it'll give that running back a full head of steam. Now, with the pressure that Clemson's defensive front three is putting on, that inside running game should go pretty well for the Gamecocks. They're turning loose the front three. They should be able to be blocked sideways.
Big holding call against the Tigers. It, of course, gave the Gamecocks that first down, so it's second and five. Ellis, bootleg. He's a right-hander, looks for a block, will pull it down. Tripped up and still manages to fall forward to the 41. Where James Earl, the senior out of Easley, South Carolina, made the hit. Michael Dean Perry. Yep, the Refridge's brother. Younger brother. Well, they have seven brothers and four sisters in that family, right?
There's a bunch of Freddies here somewhere. The older brother.
He's a 500-pounder.
He's a svelte 500-pounder.
First quarter.
That's the end of the first quarter. The only scoring. An 18-play, 9-minute drive. Put the Tigers up in front 7-0 on a 1-yard touchdown run by Wesley McFadden. Clemson leads after the first quarter 7-0. South Carolina driving for the Eagles. Along with Kevin Kiley, I'm Jim Kelly, and welcome back as ESPN Saturday Night CFA presents Clemson and South Carolina. A dandy, the 85th renewal, a great rivalry here in the South. The battle for the state of South Carolina, how important for recruiting. Third and six from the 41. Blitz, Ellis reads it, and he's got Kevin White. White to the 34-yard line. Taylor has him there. That should be a first down, a pickup of 7. First down for the Gamecocks.
Here's that front three of Clemson putting the pressure on Ellis. Now Ellis will do a nice job. The offense gives him just enough room. Perry right on his back. And look at the accuracy of the young sophomore into coverage. They don't have a tight end. South Carolina has no tight end. They have to use those wings or slots in the short patterns.
White
little guys do a good job. Excuse me.
White gets a rest. Harden Brown, the junior out of Red Springs, North Carolina. But Harold Green explodes up the middle behind Woody Myers and Charlie Gowan. Mark Drag, the junior out of Charlotte, North Carolina, on the stop.
Green, great player. 205-pound sophomore. And the youngster, he scored 3 touchdowns in 5 separate games this season. He's got 15 touchdowns. Great runner. A single back offense. They will go to the eye sometimes, but mainly a single back offense. Do it without that extra block.
Coaches call him a thoroughbred. The last minute pitches it back to Brown. John Johnson, the freshman, talk about a hit, just drove him halfway to Columbia.
Well, they run the option. It's a little strange out of the run and shoot. It's a two-step option. The motion guy, see him, he's trailing right there. Comes from the slot or the wing position. Ellis does a good job getting him the ball, but here's Clemson. Sitting out there playing it as well as you can play it. 6 people out in front of the ball carrier.
Johnson bench presses 270 pounds. He was rated perhaps the best defensive end in high school in the United States. South Carolina 1-for-3 in third down conversions. They need 4. Run and shoot goes the other way. Will not pick it up. Hammered out of bounds at the 33 by Troy Stevens, the middle guard.
Well, what a job there, Jim, by Richard McCullough, though, number 96. Just fought his way through the block. You can really tell the physical advantage that Clemson has in this game. There's number 96. I mean, he just blasted 2 offensive linemen, and he was the guy that forced Ellis out of bounds.
On 4th and 8, the ball at the 33. This could be a 49 or a 50-yard field goal try for Colin Mackey. Now, the coaches told us, Kevin, this is definitely out of Mackey's range. He's 2-for-5 between the 40 and the 49. This will be a 49-yarder. It's on its way. It's line drive, and it is up and in. Gone!
previous long was 47 yards.
Obviously the longest field goal in his career by 2 yards, but that one would have been good from 52. 13:09 left to go before halftime. The Gamecocks have closed to within 4. ESPN's exclusive presentation of CFA football brought to you by Volvo, a car you can believe in. And by MasterCard. Every time you choose MasterCard to make a purchase, we'll make a contribution to one of 6 worthy causes. Our score, the Tigers on top. They scored first, an 18-play drive that used up almost 9 minutes. But the key call, South Carolina roughing the punter, that gave the Tigers a key first down. And then that 49-yard field goal. This one, a high kick, fair caught at the 27-yard line. And that was one of the things that Coach Joe Morrison was talking about. Sort of a pooch kick. Didn't want to kick it deep because the Tigers excel on specialty teams.
Well, that was a deliberate high kick. The other thing, they were putting their first teamers on the kickoff team because they felt that their coverage team, their backups, were not doing a good enough job, and they're up against a great special teams in Clemson, so they went with their starters.
So Rodney Williams and the Tigers nursing that 4-point lead, coming out wide to the left side. Keith Jennings, the junior out of Somerville, South Carolina, in the odd pro set. Johnson and McFadden. McFadden loses the football. Picks it back up, looks for a block. He's got a wall set up the other way. A lot of running for a 1 yard gain. 2nd and 9. Roy Hart, senior out of Tifton, Georgia, the nose guard on the stop.
The bounce.
Never had it.
The bounce here, Jim. He's able to pick that thing up. Now, you're taught to just jump on that thing and don't let the other team get it. McFadden, a youngster, doesn't know that, so he picked it up and ran it back. It should have been about a 10 or 15-yard loss. He turned it into a slight gain, about a 1-yard loss. He never should have picked it up. He should have fell on it.
Jennings comes wide to the left. Cooper wide to the right. Cooper. Loose football. Tigers fell on it. Actually, about a 5-yard gain on the fumble. The tight end, Danny Pearman, out of Charlotte, North Carolina. Tigers caught a break.
Pearman only had 1 reception on the year, but this is a big fumble recovery. Pass straight out. And now watch the hit. Just a great hit from inside out. Now Pearman's going to come up and make the recovery. Ball is definitely bouncing Clemson's way so far in this game.
3rd and 3. Williams will not get the first down. The Gamecocks helped out by the right quarterback, Norman Floyd, out of Greenville, South Carolina. Floyd, who transferred from Ferrum Virginia Junior College in the middle of the semester last year, came up to make the hit. So it's 4th and 1 and a punting situation again for the Tigers.
Let's go back to that field goal by Mackey, a 49-yarder, got the crowd into it. Cut the lead, but more than anything else, proved that South Carolina could score, and now they're a little bit pumped up.
Rusty Sale back deep. Averages about 37 yards per kick. And Sterling Sharp, about 8 yards on the return, will get a chance at the 27. Dancing, and is chopped down at the 34. A 46-yard kick, an 8-yard return. The Gamecocks ball. They trail by 4 when we come back. Timmy, it's going to be a long night for Danny Simrow's Rockets down there in Hurricane Land. Ellis, 4 out of 6, 25 yards so far. Spotted at the 34, sharp in motion. A little delay. Harold Green dances up near the 39, picks up 5, 2nd and 5 coming up. Doug Brewster, the freshman on the stop, with John Johnson helping out.
It's important that they run the ball, slow down that rush. They've been laying their ears back. Defensive line for Clemson. South Carolina has to establish something on the ground to slow him down.
Wide to the left goes Danny Smith, the senior out of Atlanta, Georgia. Ellis checks over that Tiger defense. Again, they're only sending in 3. Fullback Ben Hall up the middle. Great blocking by Woody Myers and Charlie Gowan and Paul Shivers. Jesse Hatcher, the bandit, junior out of Thompson, Georgia, on the stop, an 11-yard pickup.
Well, they talked a lot about Woody Myers, had a great game against Nebraska. Just riding the nose guard out of there, good enough for Green to step in behind him and run for big yardage. Very, very important. The yardage not as important as the fact that they're able to run on Clemson, make them sit now on a defensive line and read run.
Motion by Kevin White. And the run and shoot will go the other way. On the fly, looking downfield. It is incomplete. Ryan Bethea. Good coverage on the play by Donnell Wolford. Wolford was that Kodak All-American. He comes into the game with four interceptions. One of the hardest hitters in the spring. In fact, he won the award. Like Clemson, because he grew up in the same neighborhood with an ex-Tiger, Ray Williams. So he followed him to Clemson. And then when he got to Clemson, they had a scrimmage. Williams beat him on the very first play.
Welcome to Clemson.
Second and 10 for Ellis. And almost picked off by James Lott. Lott, the sophomore, 5'9", 176, stepped in front of Danny Smith and almost came up with a big interception.
Ellis has got 18 interceptions, double his touchdown throws to this point this year, and this is why. The coverage is there all the way. Smith doesn't have a chance. He's got to play defense on Lott to get the ball away from him. Ellis couldn't even look it over there. If he was looking, he'd have seen there was coverage. Good play by Lott.
Out of Brown High School in Kannapolis, North Carolina. He played his ball for Bob Boswell. Gamecocks 26 yards on the ground, 25 in the air. White in motion. Incomplete and probably a good thing. Harold Green, the receiver, when Raymond Chavis was back in the coverage, the junior out of Aiken, South Carolina. He is 6'5", 295. And watch number 55, Jesse Hatcher, chasing down Todd Ellis.
Hatcher's a junior college All-American, just came to Clemson. This is just great team defense. Chavis sitting on the screen. Tom Harper, the defensive coordinator, has schooled him well. One guy back, one guy pressuring him, and they're able to cover it.
Donnell Wolford is back deep. Number 20, Rodney Price hands it. Oh, this beautiful kick. Wolford in traffic. Up close to the 17-yard line. 10:05 left to go. A 37-yard kick, a 4-yard return. The Tigers lead by 4. Join us on Sunday on ESPN. It all starts with game day, 11:30 Eastern time, with Chris Berman, Pete Axum, and Tom Jackson. Hey, the Ax was hot last week. A one-hour preview of all the day's games. 7 o'clock, they come right back for a one-hour recap of all the standings, scores, highlights, and features. And, of course, at 8 o'clock tomorrow night, the NFL coverage on ESPN continues. The Dolphins of Don Shula, the Cowboys of Tom Landry, Mike Patrick, Roy Firestone, and our guest analyst, Roger Staubach. The last thing I saw in the paper, it is not true that Roger wants to run for the Senate. A lot of rumors.
Well, McFadden would like to run for Clemson, and he's going to go behind Phillips. Phillips on a little trap block takes care of Windsor, but the rest of the defense, as I said, they move around a lot, and they're able to cover up for each other. The one thing that they do is run. These guys can really run defensively for the Gamecocks.
Hooper to the near side. Jennings, top of your screen. Second and 9. Up by Ken Solly, the junior out of Morristown, New Jersey. Great defensive penetration.
Sally's a backup safety, but the safety for this team is actually like a linebacker because they play that 8- and 9-man line all the time. They move those guys up. Philpott was a free safety last year. He's now the starting strong safety, or more likely, the linebacker. Sally's his backup in the game, makes the big play.
Played at free safety for 2 years, now the strong safety. Real quickly, what's the difference?
More run responsibility at strong safety. Free safety has to be quicker.
Incomplete at the 36-yard line, looking for the man they call High Noon. That's number 25, Gary Cooper. Out of Ambridge High School in Pennsylvania, Cooper. But the ball was a little bit overthrown.
Now you'll see that again, Jim. It was wide open.
8:45 left to go. You see them holding hands? South Carolina has all year to point for the Clemson game. Clemson, of course, they have to win their conference championship, and then they turn their minds to South Carolina. Sharp should bring this one out in good field position. And again, a good roll inside the 40. Dead at about the 40, or check it, at the 37-yard line.
It's a bad decision by Sharp. He had to come up, should have caught that ball. Cost himself 15 yards.
A 48-yard kick. All right, the NCAA total defense, the Sooners, followed by the Gamecocks, and the Tigers are fourth.
Well, you think about how impressive that is. South Carolina gave up 268 yards on the ground to Nebraska, and they still only average a total of 218 yards a game. If you take that out of the equation, they probably would have been number one in the nation.
Sharp in motion out of the I pro set. Comes to the far side. Crowd gets up on their feet, and upended off his feet is the quarterback, Todd Ellis. Otis Moore, number 81, the sophomore out of Augusta, Georgia, on the hit.
Strength is definitely a factor here for Clemson. They're bigger and stronger defensively than the offensive line of South Carolina. A man broke free deep. Ellis didn't have enough time, and they're putting the pressure on with three and four men rushing, allows him to play seven and eight in the secondary, and there's no one open early enough.
Moore played more snaps than any other Clemson lineman last year, redshirted back in 85. Second and 16. Ellis over the middle. The post is wide open to Danny Smith. Danny dives to the 44 where Jesse Hatcher makes the hit.
Danny Smith, another one of those big wide receivers, 6'3", 209. You can see how many receptions he has. Most of these guys will be catching in a run and shoot. We had a wide shot. It's gone. We'll show you later.
A 26-yard reception for Danny Smith. First and 10 at the 45-yard line of Clemson. Inside the 40, upended at the 37 by Dorian Marival. Marival has really come on in the last 5 weeks, Kevin. He has 40 tackles in the last 5 weeks. Redshirted back in 85. Keith Bing, number 26, now checks in at fullback, the junior out of Aiken, South Carolina. Second and three. He's got the ball inside the 35. And the Fridge junior, number 91, Michael Dean Perry, made that hit.
He's just a little guy, Michael Dean. He's only 280 pounds. Number 91. Stepping inside and able to make the tackle. Slipping the block, that can be dangerous. Sometimes you can do it, sometimes you can't. He ran around at that time, was able to close in. Now maybe, I don't know if William could do that, if he could move that quickly.
I'll tell you, if the refrigerator's playing for the Bears, this is the freezer.
Yeah, well, you know, I did the Clemson games in 1983, and Michael then was on the team, but he was just a little ice bucket compared to the refrigerator. The refrigerator was the big guy then, and he was playing all the time. They knew Michael Dean was going to be a good one. In fact, Vince Dooley of Georgia says that he's better than his brother. He can do more things.
A first down picked up by South Carolina, spotted just inside the 35. Gamecocks trail by four, but they've got something going down. Have been too much time.
Yeah, it was a penalty before the play.
So we'll check out the penalty flag. Don't forget scores and highlights coming up at halftime with Tim Brando. Big day in college football. Lots of traditional rivalries. Ohio State upset Michigan in Earl Bruce's farewell up in Ann Arbor. Of course, earlier, Oklahoma handed it to Nebraska in Lincoln. UCLA and USC to decide the Rose Bowl. let's check out the penalty.
Dead ball, delay of game prior to the play.
And another great rivalry going on, West Virginia and Syracuse. Tim Brando, what's happening?
With just moments left in the first quarter, Jim Kelly, here's what's happening. Major Harris, he'll play fake. Fake the option and find your man. It's a touchdown catch for West Virginia, and they have the lead 7-0, but the Cuse is on the march in the second quarter.
Don Nealon's team always, Kevin, plays great defense. Harold Green checks back in at the tailback, first and 15. Deep drop over the middle, and it is caught on a diving catch, and now it's ruled a trap. Incomplete at the 23 for Danny Smith. Kevin, the middle seems to be wide open for South Carolina anytime they want to go to it.
Well, they've got five receivers out. In that case, there was four receivers out. And it really depends. A run and shoot, what you do is you read the defense. So it's not a matter of throwing it to the middle. You go to the middle if they cover to the outside. Everybody's reading. There are no set patterns. So when you see them go to the middle, it's because the defense is committed to the outside.
Danny Smith. Yard pickup. If you give Danny Smith that kind of room, he'll pick you apart all night.
Well, what they're doing, see, what I just said is they read the defense and they're looking for open spots. When the receivers come out, they look for an open spot in the defense and they run to it. There's three different patterns that they have. There's a zone pattern, a man pattern, and a blitz pattern, and they have to read whatever defense they're in, one of those three, and then they go to that pattern.
Bottom of your screen, number one, Ryan Tufay. Loose football is recovered by the Gamecocks. Green fell on his own fumble. So it will bring up a fourth down situation. McCullough and Moore made the initial hits. 96 and 81 coming at you.
He had this first down. He had to turn around and go back for the ball. They jerked it around from him. He was still actually on his feet. Realized he dropped it, was able to get back. And that might save him 3 points because they're going to go for a field goal.
Alan Mackey, who earlier kicked the longest field goal of his career. This will be a 35-yard try out of a hold of Rodney Price. Trying to pull Carolina to within 1 point. On its way, it's up, and it is good! Kevin Conley, that Tiger defense, they've been bending, but they haven't broken yet.
And I'm amazed at the field goal kickers in this game. And Treadwell, an All-American, 18 for 21 on the year. But how about Mackey? I mean, Mackey, they were telling us that his range was in the low 40s. He's exceeded already twice in the biggest game of the year.
And that first one would have been good from 52.
Yeah, it landed in some guy's drink about halfway up. I was watching.
That's just soda pop. Some high octane.
There's Freddie.
You can hardly tell that he weighs. How many pounds? 500?
A reported 500 pounds. I don't know. Freddie's been on a diet. He couldn't be an ounce over 400 there, do you think?
I don't know. He's not on the Nutrisystem plan, I'll tell you that.
Yeah, when you make Michael Dean look small, though.
Again, the squib kick. And this is out of bounds at the 31-yard line. Again, by Dan Pierman, who's having a great first half.
He caught it out of bounds. It's going to be a penalty. He should have let it go out of bounds.
Again, this is all what South Carolina wanted to do was keep it away from the dangerous, elusive deep men for the Clemson Tigers.
Those are almost like onside kicks. If he kicks it any shorter, the defense is going to have time to run under it.
You know, we talked about Pierman being a tight end. He's a blocking tight end. He only has two catches in 4 years. Gotta feel like a lonesome end.
That's an average of not quite a catch a year, huh? He's a tackle, is what he is. Coley, the backup's got, he's got all of 7 catches this year, so when he gets in there, number 88, look for him to catch one.
There is Joe Henderson, who, if he gets the ball, averages 30 yards. it's a kickoff return. He won't get this one. Fair catch is called for. And falling backward is Danny Pierman, the tight end, at the 34. That last scoring drive for the Gamecocks, a 45-yard field goal by Colin Mackey. They used up 4:10 on the clock. It covered 36 yards and 8 plays. So the Gamecocks have pulled to within a point, 7-6. Everybody's looking to gain some measure of revenge from last year's tie. They talk about a tie being like kissing your sister. What a face on Danny Ford last night when we asked him what that tie was like. He went, ugh.
Close game works in Clemson's advantage because they're stronger in the fourth quarter.
Joe Henderson, 33, in a tailback. He's got the football. Looks for a block. None coming. Fights his way up close to the line of scrimmage. Second and 10 coming up. Joe Henderson, 61 carries, 325 yards, averages 5 yards a carry, and has 5 touchdowns. Very strong for the Tigers. He bench presses 305, and he's got 4.4 speed.
And he's only 5'9", 185 pounds. He got almost half of those yards against Wake Forest a couple of weeks ago. 131 in 20 carries. He's a good back, just hasn't been able to break into the starting lineup.
Option. Not much doing for Rodney Williams. It's Derek Frazier, the junior out of Atlanta, Georgia, number 90, came up and played the containment, helped out by Mac McKernan, number 48.
Again, Jim, that Gamecock defense, they move around so much. They got Williams. They don't know where he's going. See, they cover. Winds are out here covering on the pitch. Williams knows immediately he has no place to go and then has to just dive up inside. That's excellent defense.
Third and 8 coming up. Tigers. They've got that 1-point lead. Johnson, the lone running back. Complete at the 45 for Keith Jennings. Punting situation with 3:07 left in the first half.
Clemson must get yardage on first and second down. They are not a passing team, and when they get into those third and long, they're virtually helpless. Carolina coming with a blitz, playing man-to-man, and just doing well enough, plenty well enough, to stop Clemson's passing game.
Sale out of Savannah, Georgia, the junior, will kick it to Sterling Sharp, who averages 8.6 yards every punt return. Gamecocks are coming. Good kick. Hits at the 30, and this is the first one that bounds backwards. It's killed at the 33. Every Saturday morning at 11:30 Eastern Time, ESPN kicks off your Saturday with College Football Game Day, the most comprehensive hour in college football. Join Tim Brando, Beano Cook, and Kerry Ross, who is live on in Lincoln today, for features, previews, interviews, and highlights. At 4 o'clock, ESPN, another CFA doubleheader, as Bob Rathbun and Lee Corso will have a game that has yet to be announced. We'll go right down to the wire before we select that game to give you the best possible game at 4 o'clock Eastern Time on Saturday. Then Kevin and I will be in Atlanta, Georgia, and Georgia Tech. Scissored down near the 40 by Johnny Johnson, the freshman having a terrific opening half. Started the first 3 games this year, outstanding high school career.
What South Carolina wants to do, they want to get outside. McCullough needs to be able to stay on his feet. 96, he goes down, and now Ellis pulls it down. He's able to pick up about 7 yards. Now that is the game plan of South Carolina, but that's the first time they've really been able to execute it.
Delay. Not much doing. There was no hole at all. McCullough stayed at home, and Harold Green gets hammered.
Offensive line not creating any space for the running game. Clemson penetrating by use of that great physical size. And you look at these guys. Perry is 290, 280. Stevens is 300 pounds, and Chavis is 295. The backups weigh just about as much, and the offensive line for South Carolina not nearly that big and strong. So they're really outmatched.
Down, dumps it off safety valve, and Harold Green falls down. Now, you don't see that very often. Out of Ladson, South Carolina, McCullough putting pressure on Ellis. But Green, who came in with 19 catches and about a 10.5-yard average, has lost his footing. James Lott averaging about 14.5 yards. There he is. Tigers should have good field position and about a minute left on the clock. Price out of Batesburg, South Carolina. Letting the clock go down. Tigers ease up. Tigers trying to set up the return. Beautiful kick by Price. Lott at the 17. Crowd wanted a clip, but now look out, a late flag thrown from way across the field. Here comes another one. And it'll be clipping against the Clemson Tigers. A 47-yard kick, an 8-yard return. Interesting, Kevin, because both those flags were thrown from way off the play, and the official who was right on the play never called it.
Clipping on the return on the white team.
Jim, you're absolutely right. This flag was thrown 10 seconds late. This is immediately, Lott got the ball immediately. Now, we had a wide shot of this. He gets to the sideline and turns upfield before one flag comes, and then there'll be another flag after that. And I don't know why it took so long. It seemed like they threw it after he broke loose.
Both those flags were extremely late, and again, you know, to emphasize, there was an official right there by Lott, and he looked at the play and did not throw the flag.
Seemed like they reacted to the crowd noise.
First and 10 for the Tigers. 35 seconds left to go. That'll change the complexion. We're back in be careful country at the 7-yard line.
Yeah, this is a real tough spot for Clemson. They are not a very aggressive offensive team. They do not throw to the inside people much. A very, very tough place for them to be in. You look for if they're going to try and run the ball, it should be an option.
They're in the prevent. Williams will fall on the football. 30 seconds left. See if the Gamecocks will take a timeout.
Danny's got his 1-point lead. He'll take that into the locker room with him.
You know, he played basketball as a freshman at Alabama.
He's a good athlete. He was an offensive tackle. What do you say, 195-pound offensive tackle in college, all conference too.
That man was a good athlete. 14 years in the National Football League. He played 8 positions and had his jersey retired. 7-6. The Tigers got a touchdown. The Gamecocks 2 field goals. We'll come back, but first let's rejoin Tim Brando. The state of South Carolina and Clemson leads 7-6. Hi again, everybody. I'm Jim Kelly. My partner Kevin Kiley is alongside. A good first half. Clemson used up almost 9 minutes in one drive. They took 18 plays. McFadden punched it over from 1 yard up. But I really think, Kevin, you've got to go back to a controversial call, the roughing the kicker penalty that led to the Clemson touchdown.
It was especially tough. It was the opening drive and a smallish defense. We talked about it having to be on the field. Here's the look at it. Ron Rabune, number 15, is the one that's called for the penalty. I said at the time I didn't think it was a penalty. I really don't believe it was. See if you can see he's blocked. And then I don't really think the momentum is enough to knock the punter down. It's a good acting job. Very slight there, and he's blocked into it. So if you ask me, it was no penalty at all, but the official called it a penalty, and that allowed Clemson to go on an 18-play drive and take the lead, and that 7 points has really held up, Jim.
All right, we take a look at those first-half stats, partner, and as you take a look at the passing yardage, 51 yards to 62 total yards. So the game is just about as even as things are on the scoreboard right now. 7-6 Carolina on the short end by a single point. Time of possession. So Clemson and Carolina. The bragging rights. And as Danny Ford said last night, as we watched the Tigers work out here, he said it's such a big game because if you win, you don't have to listen to them talk about it for the next year. So we are just about set to go. Eric Markle, 5'9", 170 pounds out of Russellville, Arkansas, will tee it up. Joe Henderson, who is so dangerous, and Wesley McFadden, who has that touchdown run, are back deep for the Tigers of Clemson. We talked in the first half about the importance of the specialty team, especially both teams with outstanding plus kickers. 7-6, it could come down to that. The squib kick. At the 22, Henderson. Anderson, who already has a 95-yard touchdown kickoff return this year, bangs it to the 43. A 20-yard return, first and 10 for the Tigers. They lead by one.
Clemson's always been an offense that thrives on field position, and these short kickoffs by South Carolina have created field position for the Tigers. Certainly here in the second half, they'll take over on their 42-yard line.
And the stop by Matt McKernan out of Daytona Beach, Florida.
McKernan with a picture hit here for a linebacker. Playing a little deep himself. He's defended there. His defensive line keeps people off him. And then he just gets the chest, the head right in the chest. Good linebacker play. One thing about a defensive line that moves around, they will protect the linebacker.
Hoop wide to the left side. Second and seven. It back down, battles his way up near the 49. Roy Hart has him there. Tigers lead by seven. Here's what they did in the first half. Scoring drive, of course, in yellow. 18 plays, there it is. 8:47 on the clock, the touchdown run. Three plays and the interception. And they came right back, three plays and a punt. Very bad field position for the Tigers in the first half. So only that initial touchdown drive, they used up almost 9 minutes. And they led 7-6 at the intermission. Right now they're looking at third and four. It'll be a punting situation again as Lancaster gets hammered down by number 48, Matt McKernan.
Again, McKernan making a nice play again. Nobody can get to him. You can see how they're playing the gaps and they're keeping people off him. He's able to read and come up, get the head and shoulder in there, and that's the strength of the Gamecock defense.
Sale and what he has done so far tonight, three punts, averaging about 35 yards a kick. And there is Sterling Sharp. If they ever get him free, it'll be a track meet. Almost blocked. Short kick. Sharp comes up on a dead run. Fair catches at the 20. Speaking of the Gamecocks, trailing by six, how did they do in the first half? Well, on their first two possessions, things didn't go very well. They were five plays and out, three plays and out, two punts. Then a career-high field goal from 49 yards out closed the gap to just four. Another punt, another field goal, this one from 45 yards out. And another punt, and the first half ended just 1 point apart. 7-6, Gamecocks closed within one. They've got the ball, 12:58 as we start this third quarter. Ellis, the run and shoot. All day, over the middle. Kevin White at the 35. First down, South Carolina. Dunn beaten on the coverage.
And the key to that play was the time he had in the backfield. Watch Ellis. Look at the protection. Look at the room he has back there. He has time to pump and then go to Kevin White. It's not a great throw. A little bit behind him, but actually better because it was away from the defender and a big first down.
Crossed the 37-yard line. Tony Stevens, the senior out of Walterboro, South Carolina, number 65 on the stop. He started 20 of the last 22 games.
Maybe the best matchup here, 57 Myers against Stevens. Stevens a little bit high, but gets rid of Myers immediately and is able to get over into the hole and make the tackle. Nice play by Tony Stevens, who is a good one in a long tradition of pretty good middle guards at Clemson. Remember William Perry and Devane. William Devane, who played the same year as William Perry.
Sideline. The good pump fake set it up by Ellis.
Well, Wolford wouldn't let him come inside, but the ball was thrown where he thought he was going to go, but Wolford, number 20, was screening him from the ball. I don't believe he was playing the ball at all, but he was playing the man. We're going to see the end of it. Watch the positioning. Now, finally gets turned around. You get into it a little bit late, but it's a penalty on Wolford against Bethea and another first down. And again, the protection excellent for Ellis.
At the 49-yard line of the Tigers, Harden Brown, number 11, the junior out of Red Springs, North Carolina, checks in at wingback. Wide to the left, Danny Smith. Sharp and Brown like that to the right. Harold Green hammers up to the 45-yard line. James Earl on the stop, the senior out of Easley, South Carolina. Earl, who started 22 games in a row, the only member of his class not to be redshirted. Leading tackler was 68. Came to Clemson as a quarterback. Shifted to the safety spot as a freshman. Looks like Andy Hedden as a quarterback and a safety.
And Terrence Mack also. They do that a lot. They'll take quarterbacks to make them defensive ends.
Second and six. There goes Green. That's a first down for South Carolina. Inside the 40 all the way down to the 37. And James Earl again.
Young freshman, 280-pound, number 68, Calvin Stevens, coming out here on the side, making the trap block. And there's Green, just a sophomore. A lot of good youngsters on this South Carolina team. Now, Green's an interesting story, a guy that was recruited by Clemson. Danny Ford told him he should be a tailback in an I formation. He opted to go to Carolina and be a single back, which is a tougher way to go for a running back.
Danny Ford says that Harold does things you just can't coach. From the 37, first and 10. Ellis in the run and shoot will try to pull it down. Out of bounds at the line of scrimmage. Maybe a short pickup of one. Mark Drag, 6'4", 255, chasing down Todd Ellis, who's 6'3", 210.
Ellis is just not quick enough. He had running room, but he just does not have great foot speed. He couldn't turn it up. Green made a terrific block on the corner. Let him get outside. Just does not have great running speed. If they could do something to improve him, that's what it would be.
They like his arm.
They'll take his arm, yeah. That's interesting, a run and shoot. He'll be a drop back quarterback in the pros when he makes it, when he goes pro. But the run and shoot is really not suited for him as a runner.
Ellis, 8 of 16, 78 yards, second and 10 coming up. The run and shoot goes the other way. Over the middle, and it is batted down at the 28 and almost intercepted by Vince Taylor, number 58. Taylor, no interceptions on the year, and you can see those heavy gloves. 42 tackles. He's the best Clemson linebacker, they say, at the bench press since Jeff Davis.
And Taylor is better against the run. Here's Sharp trying to get him on a crossing pattern. He's got his man beat, but Ellis never sees Taylor, who's drifting over in front to the right. We don't see him, but he was standing in front there, and that was triple coverage to begin with. Taylor was the fourth guy, and we didn't even see him. Not a good selection by Ellis.
Third and 10, a big third down play. Sharp motions top of the screen. All day, middle's open, a sliding catch incomplete at the 15-yard line. Ryan Bethea on the post, and Richard Smith, the junior out of Spartica, Georgia, was back there on the coverage. Smith out of Hancock Central High School played his high school ball for John Flynn. Once scored four touchdowns on 210 yards, had 10 solo tackles in the same game.
Clemson is doing what Georgia did. Georgia gave up a lot of yards to South Carolina, but only 6 points.
This punt looks for the coffin corner. Goes about 10 yards too deep, so the Tigers dodge a bullet, and they'll start from their own 20. A 37-yard punt, no return. Clemson leads by one. There's our score. Time left in the third quarter. Lots of time. They tied 21 all last year. Clemson leads the series. 49 victories to 31 for South Carolina. There have been four ties. This, the 85th meeting. Out of the eye pro set. Almost a misdirection. And Williams was lucky to get the fullback to Tracy Johnson. That was very close to being a fumble. Short pickup over the right side of 2 yards. Brings up second down and 8 inside of 10 minutes when the ball is snapped now. Some of the color. And this is certainly a tremendous rivalry. Historic for you coming up. The man they call High Noon, Gary Cooper, at the top of your screen.
He pulls it down, and it is incomplete. Jennings, the intended receiver. Remember, we talked a little bit about the rivalry. One game comes to mind back in 1961. Clemson fans erupted as their team apparently came out onto the field. But it wasn't their team. It was a fraternity that had stolen or borrowed some high school jerseys that looked exactly like the Tigers. And it was kind of like the Keystone Cops. The center snapped the ball 40 yards high. They did some bad calisthenics. And when it was over, they realized it was a prank. South Carolina students had pulled on the Clemson kids. Caught at the 38-yard line. That will be a first down. Ricardo Hooper.
I tell you, this looks bad. This looks like a terrible play. It looked like it wanted to be a screen off the back foot, a floater. I don't know. He just gets him there. Hooper's right there to make the catch. It is a nice catch. And a first down for Clemson. So Williams incomplete, Manny, and he's happy about that one.
Inside handoff. It goes to Johnson. Tries to reverse his field. Penalty flag thrown. That might be a face mask.
Yeah, it looked like Johnson did a nice job spinning out of that thing. He almost got loose. Appeared somebody got his hand in his face.
Got a hand in the face, but the penalty will go against the Clemson Tigers.
Yeah, Danny doesn't like that one.
Clemson fans didn't like that prank I was talking about either back in 1960. They stormed out onto the field after they discovered it was a prank, a fraternity trick. Order was restored and they renewed the rivalry.
The penalty is an illegal block below the waist, somewhere in that pile.
So a penalty will back up the Tigers now. It's first and 21, spotted at their own 27-yard line. It was a penalty against South Carolina that led the Tigers' touchdown, roughing the kicker. Five penalties, 50 yards against the Tigers. Williams fires incomplete. Cooper turned it inside. The ball was thrown outside.
Clemson again, not effective when they are predictable. They're a pounded out type of team. Now, in a position like this, you have to look for draws and screens. And remember, the tight end is not a leading receiver, neither is the tailback. Makes defense a little bit easier.
The book on Rodney Williams so far this evening. 9-16. Keith Jennings wide to the left side. It'll be all right. Johnson and McFadden. McFadden with a touchdown. Needs a block. One man, and he was gone. Brad Edwards saved the touchdown. The senior out of Fayetteville, North Carolina.
Predictions, situations like this, South Carolina will come hard. Here's Windsor, number 20. Everybody got there. He had his head down, actually. By the time he turned around, you see the ball is gone. And this is a draw. It's a sprint out draw is what it is. Fullback leads to the outside, and then they're looking for McFadden to cut back inside. And one man to go, and he'd have been gone. Now, they should have been looking for that.
Goes to the sideline. Great leaping catch by Gary Cooper. He's got a 34 and a half inch vertical jump, and he can do 81 sit-ups in a minute.
Well, he used all of that 34 and a half inches. The spot here is going to be short of the first down. Williams does a nice job, as you see the defender falling down, getting him the ball, and then the spot. I'll tell you, that spot, maybe he spotted that ball back a half a yard. It's going to be short of the first down. Looked to me like he had it. Now Clemson, the strength of the Clemson team is the offensive line. They're on the 48-yard line. You would think that they could get this first down. They've got a half yard to go. Danny Ford's going to let his offense try for it. Now watch out for the count here, too. What they sometimes do, they'll change up the count, try to get the defense to jump off sides.
Johnson, Lancaster, McFadden, a full house backfield. The quarterback will dive. Williams goes over the center behind Jeff Back. Back, who started all 10 games at center this year and 12 of them last year. No Clemson player offensively or defensively has been in on more plays than Jeff Back.
And they went right behind Back.
He might be the strongest in the weight room. They say he bench presses 450 yards.
or 450 pounds. That might feel like 450 yards.
I was going to say, how much does 450 yards weigh?
Take a look at the line surge, the leg strength. Here's where that weight room comes in. They're very low. And Williams carried the ball by his knee, which is, takes a long time to get it over the first down marker. He finally brings it up by his waist, and it's enough for a first down. Confidence by Danny Ford in that offensive line, it paid off. And Carolina has not played well defensively when they've been on the field a long time in this game. That's a big first down.
Quick handoff, it goes to Tracy Johnson, and he approaches midfield. All right, a couple of big games going on. Tulane and LSU, Syracuse and West Virginia. Let's go back with Tim. All right, so LSU and West Virginia hanging tough, and so are the Gamecocks defensively right there. Stacked up and going nowhere. Daniels, a great defensive play, number 91. Brings up third and long. This is what the Gamecocks try to do. They want to force Clemson into a passing situation where they're not sure how many men that man, Joe Lee Dunn, is sending.
And you can bet they're going to come after him. Now, an aggressive defense, sometimes you want to run a reverse. Third down, really not a good time for a reverse, but misdirection works very well against an aggressive defense.
Look out. Second on the year. He transferred from Pratt Community College in Kansas. Had an up and down spring. The coaches said he needed consistency. He might have found it.
This play is supposed to be a swing pass to the tailback. He never has time. Tailback, they finally take him out of there. Didn't use him for blocking, and that was the result. The tailback swung, and Williams went down under pressure. There was that blitz that Jim talked about.
Sale back at his own 26. Sharp awaiting at the 20. A high, high kick. Sharp lets it hit, and it bounces backwards by about a yard. That sack by Derek Frazier out of Frederick Douglass High School in Atlanta. If the name's familiar, his uncle is Walt. He used to play with the Knicks. Along with Kevin Kiley, I'm Jim Kelly, and welcome back here at Columbia, South Carolina. The Gamecocks trailing the Tigers by one. 5:31 left to go, and the Tigers have outscored their opponents 154-56 in the second half. How about 90-35 in the fourth quarter?
It's an indication of strength and physical ability wearing people down.
From the 17, Kevin White motions far side. The run and shoot. Ellis lost his footing. The middle's wide open. Ryan Buffet will go inside the 10. Team in yards per catch, Kevin, last year.
And Ellis rolls to the left and throws back to the middle, and he's wide open. And now you're going to see what size does. 6'3", 208 pounds. He's a horse, this guy. And he's down the road. They can't pull him down. Finally, you'll see Wolford after Green makes a great block right there. Wolford tracking him from behind. Big, huge wide receiver making the play.
Number 60,
Keith Bing, number 26, and then Harold Green, number 22, Watch him lead him right into the end zone. And we talked about skill people. Ellis is a great one, but they have the skill people too. Ryan Bethea, Harold Green, two plays back-to-back, and they're in the end zone for the first time tonight. There's Green.
A six-point lead after a one-point deficit. 4:58 left to go. Eric Markham out of Russellville, Arkansas, will kick it away. Again, that squib kick. Fair catch is signaled for at the 29-yard line. Again by Dan Pierman, the tight end. Scoring drive. How about this one, Kevin? Two plays, 83 yards, 33 seconds. Harold Green, his 14th rushing touchdown.
You know, just two plays, but typical of why South Carolina is so effective offensively, averaging 441 yards per game. There's Bethea. He's considered to be the top pro prospect on the team, even with Sharp and Ellis on the team. He is considered to be the best. He's huge, got great hands and great speed. They use the run and shoot to get down the field, then a straight eye formation to go in.
Motion by Jennings. His way up to the 34-yard line. Robert Robinson has him there, the junior out of Shelby, North Carolina.
McFadden's got to be getting tired. Now, McFadden has not been asked to play the whole game. With Terry Allen out with a broken rib, McFadden has played quite a bit of this game, and he's only been playing about half and switching off with Allen at tailback for Clemson most of the year.
Second and five from the 34. Talked about the rivalry. This is the way they dress now, but it wasn't too many years ago, Kevin, that this rivalry, it was a fashion plate. It was like going to the Kentucky Derby. There'd be suits and ties. The women would wear furs. Everybody would dress up. High heels for the ladies. Not anymore.
Dress like you and I, Jim.
Yes, and you've got some great heels.
Thank you. Seven and eight man line, and these guys can run. Jolie Dunn said, I'll tell you what, they may be small, but they can run. And here's an example of just how well they do run. Getting to the sideline and stopping a pitch man.
Sale getting a busy night, almost blocked the kick. Gamecocks were coming. Sterling Sharp. Fair catches at the 24. Boy, you can't come much closer to blocking the punt. A 44-yard punt. But watch Stephon Williams. He comes in from the left side and almost blocked that punt. Carolina leads by six.
He felt like that a couple mornings.
Yeah. That about tells the story, doesn't it?
From the 24, Sharp motions far side. Last time the Gamecocks had the ball, they went 83 yards in two plays. This time, Harold Green with that six-yard touchdown scamper chopped down. Loose football.
Yeah, it was a fumble. That's a strange-looking play. Harold Green had dropped the ball, and they're going to spot it where it was recovered.
Picked up 3 yards on the fumble.
And here's Green. He tripped up by his own guy. Ball is loose before he hits the ground.
Brewster had a shot at it.
Smith is able to come in and make the recovery. I think people realize how close that was.
Keith Bing out of Aiken, South Carolina, now the fullback. A little dance and a little deliver, and there he goes. Out of bounds. Richard Smith saved the touchdown. Bing came in for that one play. Good speed, a good first step to the hole.
The difference between the two backs may be that first step. See how quick he gets through a huge hole. Again, some good blocking by Woody Myers, and he's off to the races. And you're right, Jim, one more step, and he'd have been out of there, down to the end zone.
Well, we talked about Frazier, whose uncle is Walt Frazier. Keith Bing, his uncle is Dave Bing. Used to be with the Detroit Pistons.
I think these two guys could take on ESPN All-Stars next Friday morning.
What? You and I need oxygen on Friday morning. All right. Jones carries up, pick up 1 yard, second down and 9 coming up. Also coming up on ESPN Game Day, 11:30 Eastern Time tomorrow. Chris Berman, Tom Jackson, Pete Axsome, and of course they'll all be back with highlights, scores, and standings at 7 o'clock Eastern Time, and at 8 o'clock the Dolphins and the Cowboys. Shula against Landry again. Two of the great teams, two of the great coaches, Mike Hattrick, Roger Staubach, and Roy Firestone. On second and 9. Jones, number 24, the fullback. Now, was he drawn off?
It's a tough call. Now, the offensive tackle moved, but he's allowed to move and get set again as long as
dead
he wasn't
ball,
set.
Foul, interior lineman raising up.
You saw that Miami score leading Dan Simmel and his Toledo Rockets in 2 weeks. We'll be seeing the Hurricanes at home against these same South Carolina Gamecocks.
That'll be a good one. Now, Clemson defense has not played with the same intensity that they played with in the first half. They've not gotten the pressure, nor have they played the run as well. I don't know if they're tired. They're just not getting it done, or South Carolina's line has asserted themselves.
Open. Ellis wants the post, fires, and it is incomplete, almost intercepted at the 10. Gene Beasley, the junior out of Atlanta, Georgia, had a better shot than the intended wide receiver, Sterling Sharp. Double coverage.
Things were caving in for Ellis on this play. Here's Sterling Sharp going deep. Ball should never have been thrown again. There's triple coverage out there. Sharp having to play defense. Ellis has thrown a couple of those. Remember, even though he's got the records, he's just a sophomore.
From the 49, third and 14. Slot to the right. White and Bethay. Now motion across by Sharp. Sack at the 42-yard line. The Fridge's brother, the little Fridge, Michael Dean Perry.
Just talked about Clemson's defensive line not asserting themselves. 91. Just does a little slip right around the blocker and in. And absolutely no resistance from the line, and he's able to get Ellis right away. It's a big defensive series for Clemson, trailer by 6.
You know, William and Michael went to different high schools, by the way. Entered a condominium to get him in. 4th and 19. Wolford watches arms out of bounds at the 40, or check at the 33-yard line. Other scores. Following that 25-yard punt, LSU now has increased their lead to 2 touchdowns over Tulane. Illinois State over Northern Iowa by 10. Tech by a touchdown against Houston. And Tulsa, tough time again. Boise State and Idaho deadlocked at 3 touchdowns apiece. Don't forget Air Force in Hawaii coming up. Doubleheader night for you on ESPN. Over the middle, incomplete at the 40-yard line for Mr. High Noon, Gary Cooper. Sophomore out of Ambridge, Pennsylvania.
That thing was wide open. It was a bad pass by Williams. They went to two tights with play action, and they had it. Williams would have laid that thing out a little bit.
Williams, 6 out of 12, 1 interception, 75 yards. Slips and falls for a loss of 7.
Now you may be wondering about a backup quarterback. For Clemson, he's a guy named Chris Morocco. He started the Wake Forest game, did not have a good first half. They had to replace him with an injured Rod Williams. Williams came in and has played very well since then, but they don't want to have to go with Morocco. They don't feel he has the experience that Williams has. Williams needs to just play better.
Morocco's only thrown 13 times, completed 6, the son of the legendary Zippy Morocco. On 3rd and 17. McFadden will carry. Danny Ford, in effect, is saying we can't pass for the first down. 19 seconds, left in this third quarter. Now, Clemson excels in the fourth quarter. They were hoping to wear South Carolina down. Trailing by six, they'll have to.
Well, one of the things they're not doing, though, when they pass on first down and they don't establish a run or get some first downs, Carolina won't be worn down by the fourth quarter. You wear them down by pounding them for three quarters, and Clemson has not done it since early in the game.
15 minutes left in the 85th renewal between South Carolina and Clemson. The Gamecocks lead by six. On fourth and 17 and trailing by six, we start the fourth quarter. Sale, six kicks, 40 yards, 49 is longest to Sharp. Derek Hedges at the 33. So the Gamecocks have the ball, Kevin Kiley. They've got a six-point lead, and they've got good field position.
6 points may not be enough in this game. They can't afford to get complacent.
Storyline, Columbia, South Carolina, an 18-play drive for a touchdown, helped out by a controversial call roughing the kicker. Clemson led 7-0, but Mackey, two field goals, one a career longest, 49 yards, drew them within one at halftime, and there were the total yards. But then Columbia watched the homeboys, the Gamecocks, come right back with an 83-yard drive in two plays. They took 33 seconds to get the go-ahead touchdown. Harold Green, a 6-yard scamper, and that's where we are. Ellis pulls it back down. Looks for somebody to come back and help him out. Almost bumps into the referee and dances down at the 30-yard line. Tony Stevens has him there. Not the first time, perhaps, that...
Clemson has done a great job in coverage today. I mean, this is a team that averages 440 yards. And look at all the guys back there. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 people back, putting pressure on with four. They cover everybody, and then they're able to get Ellis out of bounds. Except for that one big play now to Bethea, they've really done a pretty good job. And they've gotten pressure from the front three in doing.
A loss of four brings up second and 14. Middle is open. Danny Smith in a crossing pattern. Danny Smith, first down South Carolina at midfield. James Earl on the coverage.
Here's the difference in the second half is the protection for Ellis. He's been under some pressure, but he's had time and is able to find Smith, who's isolated on James Earl. Now, James Earl is an outside linebacker, weighs 225 pounds, and Clemson will ask their outside backers to cover man-to-man sometimes. Ellis found him and was able to hit the pass.
Smith, three catches, 58 yards. White motions top. Fullback, bang, backwards. Maybe the line of scrimmage goes Harold Green, and Stevens has him there.
Clemson's defense is really leads the team. I mean, it's a type of team that the defense makes a lot of big plays, and now's the time with just under 14 minutes to go in the fourth quarter. The defense needs to ignite the offense, which has really gone to sleep. They're a little bit flat. They need to get them going by making a big play.
Big defensive series for the Tigers. They have to keep Columbia's Gamecocks off the board. Another field goal makes it a 9-point margin. Clemson Tigers would need two scores. Scrimmage, though, looked like they had the draw play set up very well, but they closed off the seams very quickly.
Well, those linebackers sitting there deep, Jim, you know, when you're sitting deep, it's a lot easier to see what happens. You'll give up a yard or two. It's really a problem on first down, but not so much a problem if you stop on first down, because you can afford to give up 3-4 yards on second down. Makes it easier to play the position from a sight seeing sense, not so much when you have to meet linemen because they get a head start.
Big third down play here on third. Chain. Lott was beaten on the play. Smith knew where the first down yardage was. He picked it up.
A bad combination here. Lott sitting off the receiver, and then the defensive front three not getting pressure. See, there's five blocking three. Then you give Ellis that kind of time and give Smith that kind of room on the corner, and this is the result. Look at the space that Lott has given Smith, and you can see the mismatch on the line. Clemson's got to send more than three people now.
Ellis now 11 of 19, 188 yards passing, puts it in the red basket, pulls it back out, gives to Kevin White, and Kevin White explodes around the left side, close to another Gamecock first down.
Now, We thought maybe South Carolina would get tired, but it looks like maybe Clemson not getting outside. They go to the option. White, number six, is the trailer. They're shutting off the inside. Ellis does a nice job waiting and getting it to White, and White turning it upfield. And Clemson not there on the outside.
Kevin White came to South Carolina as a quarterback, remember. Second and two. Tackle. Let's talk about South Carolina now. We talk about Clemson wearing down the Gamecocks. The reverse is happening. The Tiger defense has been out there a long time in the second half, and the offensive line taking command for South Carolina.
13 fourth quarter points versus South Carolina in 9 years under Danny Ford. And I think that's an indication of just a physical mismatch. But as Jim points out, well, the run and shoot tool will run you around, and the big people, it appears, are getting tired for Clemson, those big heavy linemen.
Down for South Carolina. Green behind the blocking of Woody Myers, Paul Shivers, Mark Pryor, and Calvin Stevens. They're almost down now to four down territory.
Stevens is the center that had such a great year. Excuse me, the guard, Calvin Stevens. He's going out and picking off the linebacker, and that's a problem with playing back that far. Like I said, the offensive lineman is able to get that running start against you. Calvin Stevens, a freshman, playing on an offensive line. He beat out Pat Williams, who was a starter.
Brown and Bing into the lineup for South Carolina. Timeout on the field. 11:14 left to go. Carolina leading Clemson by six, but the Gamecocks are driving. Let's take timeout. From the 21, first and 10. Clemson needs a turnover. Pitchback. Keith Bing. Penalty flag is down. And so is Bing in the grasp of James Earl. This will be a big holding call.
Just mean it earlier in that timeout, they brought the entire defense over to the sideline. Danny Ford talking to his entire defense just inside the end line, trying to get him going here and trying to make him understand how important this defensive series is. And then they get a break here on this holding call. Danny Ford's a guy, I knew him in 1983 when I did the Clemson package. He's a completely different person. Still got a nice voice, same as he had then, but he's changed quite a bit. He's a more open guy, more relaxed. Back then, they were on probation. He was a little tense. He still seems, of course, he's tense in this game. He's a pretty good guy, and he's loosened up a lot. Enjoys it for us.
On first and 17, loose football. Tigers have got it at the 47-yard line. Jesse Hatcher, number 55. Came up with a crucial fumble recovery. He came in with one interception, seven sacks, and one block kick. A transfer from Taft Junior College in California.
He was the most valuable player in the Junior College National Championship last year. Ellis, no chance, trying to pitch it there to White. White's not even there, and now Hatcher with a great speed in position. The defense really didn't do it. A penalty on the offense, and then the defense happened to be in the right place when Ellis made a bad pitch, but that could ignite the offense. Remember the physical advantage we talked about. Let's see if Clemson goes to the running game and tries to pound it in from here.
First and 10 from the 47. Full house backfield. Big hole right side. Almost a fumble. McFadden behind the block of Eric Harmon, John Phillips, and Jeff Back.
Against Nebraska, South Carolina was in the game. In the fourth quarter, Nebraska had a 96-yard drive, went 9.5 minutes, and pounded it into the end zone. Clemson knows that, and so does South Carolina.
Second and seven. Into the bread basket, McFadden pulls it down. Greg Philpott on the stop. Williams stopped by Robinson and Philpott.
Carolina's defense, where are they going to be? Where are they going to be? You see Windsor closing. He's got the dive guy and then everybody outside. Williams has not done a great job as a pitch quarterback tonight. He has not really made the decision to turn it upfield quick enough. They need to make that inside running game work.
Slot to the left. Jennings outside. Hooper inside. Incomplete at the 42-yard line. Greg Philpott putting pressure on Rodney Williams.
An opportunity for Clemson to be in four down territory. They ran inside on the first down, gained about 5 yards, then tried to go outside and lost ground, and it never did work out. Seems to me with an offensive line like that, they could go four downs when they take over near midfield and try to pound it in and keep that defense on the field. That's their only chance in this game.
Out of Savannah, Georgia, the junior has had a busy night. Blowing on the fingers, trying to warm up the hands, and there is Sterling Sharp. Signals for the fair catch. 9:21 left to go. Carolina leads Clemson by 6. Along with Kevin Farley, I'm Jim Kelly. A huge defensive series right now for the Clemson Tigers. They'd like nothing better than force Carolina three plays and punt from the shadow of their own end zone. The run and shoot run right at you with Harold Green. Explodes across the 20-yard line, first down South Carolina, and the middle guard made the tackle, so you know the offensive line did their job.
Well, they've been going wide now for the last two series, and they've got Bing in the backfield. This was an I formation. Watch Shivers, number 71. He's going to pull, and then number 26 out in front right there. Excellent block. And Green running the ball, picking his hole. That's good wide play offensively. Tire out that defense.
19 carries, 82 yards, and a touchdown for Green. He'll go the other way. Penalty five is down. Beasley on the stop. The groan from the crowd should tell you, Kevin, looks like holding against South Carolina.
You've got better eyes than I do.
I said the groan.
I said he got better eyes than I do. I didn't see it.
Holding on the offense.
There it is. They've had a couple of costly holding penalties. Nothing running the ball wide does. It'll use more of the clock. Carolina sitting on a very tenuous 6-point lead.
Joe Morrison graduated from Cincinnati back in 59 in his fifth year as the head coach in South Carolina. Started out at the University of Tennessee at Chattanooga in 73. Was recommended for the job by an old adversary and a teammate, Sam Hawk. On to New Mexico, coached the Lobos, had back-to-back 4-7 records, then went 10-1 in his third year. And here come the Gamecocks. First and 18. So Clemson would like to force a turnover or make the punt. Ellis gives it off to Harold Green. Hammers his way over the right side where Raymond Chavis makes the stop. On Sunday, tomorrow, 12:30 Eastern time, final NASCAR race of the season. 500-mile race, 328 laps. Dale Earnhardt is the defending champion. And, of course, is closing in on becoming the second driver in motorsports history to win more than $2 million in 1 year. Bill Elliott, the only other driver, he won $2 million back in 1985. We'll have that race for you. It'll be a good one. 12:30 Eastern time. Green. Feeling nobody else is going to see the ball but Harold Green for a while here. Carolina content to work on the clock. 9:48, 9:47. Ticking down. McCullough and Chavis on the stop again. You throw the ball now on third and 11.
If they do, it'll be a backside crossing pattern. They roll Todd Ellis one way. If he has time, he'll turn around and try and hit that backside receiver crossing. They've had really great success with that thing. Isolate them on a linebacker or that defensive end on the backside. Something safe for sure.
Danny Smith getting single coverage over on the left side of your screen, on the top side of the screen. Green gets a block from Smith. Runs out of bounds. Clock is stopped. 7:10. Lock chased him out of bounds. So that's it's a vote of confidence for the South Carolina defense.
He's going to make Clemson win this game, and the only way they're going to win it is on the ground. They have yet to go to it yet, exclusively off tackle, which is the strength of their team.
You send everybody and try to block this punt. Rodney Price, back deep. They've got the return set up. This is a line drive kick. Lott backpedaling at the 42. Looks for a blinder. Going the wrong way. Great special teams. At the 33, a loss of 10. Shed Diggs, number 42 for the Gamecocks, who lead by 6 when we come back.
James Lott, fourth leading punt returner in the nation. Carolina was worried about the special teams of Clemson. They put their starters in on punt coverage. And here's Shed Diggs, outside linebacker, start for the defense, making the tackle. Strategy worked.
First and 10 for the Tigers. They start 67 yards away from the end zone. They need a touchdown or two field goals. It goes to the tailback, McFadden. Kurt Wilson, number 92, the sophomore out of Middlesex, stacked him up there. 74,000 plus in attendance now. This game is always a sellout. The bragging rights for the state of South Carolina. It was sold out in 1946 and then some. Two counterfeiters from New York printed up 5,000 extra tickets. They closed the gates. They knocked the gates down. The spectators were out on the field. They kind of followed the action from hash mark to hash mark. If a play came toward them, the spectators went the other way. Going the wrong way, Rodney Williams. Greg Philpott has him there.
Williams did not handle the snap from center. Dropped it right there and caught it midair. By that time, everybody was gone. He's having a rough night, Williams.
Got a big play call right here, Kevin. Third and 13. 6 minutes.
The thing that really hampers Clemson is they cannot throw the ball over the middle. Their tailbacks are not good receivers. Their tight ends have 8 catches between them for the year. Their starting tight end has 1. So they're really hampered when they need that 8, 10 yards, or 13 in this case, for first down, and Williams having problems, calls timeout.
The clock was winding down. They might have been penalized for too much time. You saw the indecision by Danny Ford. He started to signal for a timeout a couple of times. And by the time the indecision reached the huddle said, okay, now what do? We'll take timeout. 5:46 left to go, and Carolina nursing that 6 points.
Jim, Clemson has rushed this half 19 times for 13 yards.
And if they try to rush for 13 now, this crowd will really go crazy.
They average 261 a game.
Williams has to put it up. Deep drop. Looks. Far sideline. It's picked off. Brad Edwards will get a convoy. Touchdown, South Carolina. Carolina as a quarterback out of Douglas Byrd High School in Fayetteville, North Carolina.
Well, it all goes back to Clemson's lack of a tight end and a tailback. They're just too predictable, and Edwards, one of the best safeties in the country, was sitting on that pass to the wideout. Williams does not have the strength in his arm, and that's the net result of it. Williams knows it. It's a tough position to put a quarterback in. A guy who has nobody to throw to over the middle cannot get it to the outside. That's what will happen.
Swim kick. Tigers will start just shy of their own 40-yard line. Go back a year ago in the annual battle that began in 1896. Brad Edwards returned a 61-yard interception for a touchdown.
Well, anytime you become predictable against a great defense, I'll tell you another factor in this game. South Carolina has literally dared Clemson with field position on every kickoff, and they've had two field goals and two touchdowns, plus their other kickoff. They've had five kickoffs. They have given them field position, and Clemson has not done anything about it.
Tigers have lots of time left, 5.5, but they've got to get some scores quickly. The receiver falls down, and this one is incomplete at midfield. Norman Floyd, number 29, had a chance to put the ball away. Ricardo Hooper slipped and fell at midfield.
Again to the wideout, and again a weak throw. But it's unbelievable how they will not throw down the center of the field. I mean, these balls are floaters. The key just does not have a strong enough arm to throw on the run like that. And now South Carolina is sitting on him out there waiting for it. They've got to throw it up the middle. They've got to find a way to get a tailback to the wing or somebody who can catch it over the middle.
Williams, 6 of 14, 2 interceptions. Goes for all of it, looks downfield, incomplete at the 25-yard line. That was almost a desperation pass. Penalty flag is down in the backfield.
Face mask on the offense.
Well, there's a call you don't see very often.
That's an interesting call.
Asked Danny Ford last night if one of his kids came to him and said, "Coach, I'd like to be just like you, be a head football coach," what advice he might give them. And he said, if it isn't too late, go back and major in psychology, because how young people's minds work nowadays, how you motivate them, how you touch a young man, how you try to reach them and read their emotions, so difficult. There's so many outside influences.
The game has changed. There's no question from the time that Danny Ford played, from the time that I played. Kids are different. They're more complicated.
Penalty declined. 3rd and 10. This could be the ball game right here. Clemson, they trail by 13. They desperately need a first down. Jennings comes out wide to the left. Lancaster and McFadden in the I pro set. Everybody's coming. This one's picked off at the 45. Edwards again. And a penalty flag is down at the 43. That ball never should have been thrown by Williams.
Well, he should have thrown it, but I'll tell you what he did. Now, Coley, the substitute tight end, was in the game. The kid with 7 catches, and he was breaking clear down the middle. What Williams did was he never got set.
Williams right there was saying to Danny, "I didn't see him."
Watch 88. Just slip the block top center of your screen. See, he's gone. But Williams never set and just laid it up short. Coley, if he'd have thrown that thing out there, Coley would have had it right down the center of the field. And that thing's been open all day, and they have just not thrown it. Okay, here's Williams. Turns his back. He's got to get set. Watch him throw up his back foot. He does nothing. He can't do it. I mean, you got to step to the side and get set. There's no use throwing the ball like that.
Edwards now with 8 interceptions right there. One shy of the record.
Edwards was beat on that play. They got the
Green and the Tiger defense stiffens. 2nd and 9 coming up. Tigers can't lay back anymore. They have to force a fumble. There is the young man out of Douglasburg High School, played for Bob Paroli, Fayetteville, North Carolina. He was a quarterback, passed for 1,200 yards, ran for 400, 22 touchdowns, and threw a no-hitter in baseball.
I'll tell you a story about him. He was a quarterback until he took over for Donnell Wolford, who was an All-American quarterback at Clemson. Clemson fell in love with the free safety position after Wolford was hurt at the same high school.
Green again on second and eight, tries to get outside. Chopped down at the 44-yard line by James Lott. Four scores coming up with Tim Brando. Timmy, what's happening?
By Owens, it's 17-16. Back to Jim.
They got a barn burner going in the dome. Shy of first down yardage goes Green. Michael Dean Perry on the stop. Green now, 24 carries, 98 yards, approaching the century mark. Clock is stopped, 3:42 left to go. North Carolina leading by 13, and the Tigers take a timeout. So while Clemson tries to regroup after two back-to-back interceptions, we'll take a timeout. 3:42 left. There's our time left. Carolina with a 13-point lead after back-to-back interceptions by Brad Edwards. One coming up. Rice just got that one away. No flag. This one sails out of bounds. Let's get an update on West Virginia and Syracuse again. Here's Tim Brando.
Game live where Tom Mees is standing by. Back to Jim and Kevin.
That 44 is a pretty famous number up at Syracuse, Timmy. First and 10, 75 yards away for the Tigers. Williams has to be shell-shocked. Stands, fires, incomplete. How have the Tigers done in the second half? Lousy.
11 plays, 22 yards, and a punt. That was their most successful, and then you can see what a job the South Carolina defense has done. Joe Lee Dunn, this is basically the same defense, different alignment. They ran a 4-3 last year. They went over 50 with a pressure defense, second in nation.
Williams, not going to make up 13 points that way. Brendan McCormick, the senior out of Chicago, number 95. Four sacks on the year. Started this year with a bad knee, a bad back. When he's healthy, he's a major force out of Gordon Tech in Chicago. Inside of 3 minutes when the ball is snapped, Kevin, in third and 12.
Again, tight end. That's who I'd be looking for. We've got double tights, looking for 88 on this play.
Three-man run. Williams looks over the middle, fires, misfires. Wasn't even close to Keith Jennings. Gotta be rattled when your last two have been picked off, one for 40 yards for a touchdown. You throw that high, it's just a sign like in baseball you're releasing too early, and he knew it.
They're asking him to do things he can't do. Their offense is so limited. They're giving him two receivers, both wide outs. Carolina's all over him, and then they're asking a kid with an average arm to throw the ball in there. He has no chance to succeed in this offense.
Sharp is back deep. Risk the fumble, makes a good bounce for the Clemson Tigers, and is dead at the 21-yard line. 2:38 left to go on this one. Coming up every Saturday, Tim Brando, Beano Cook, and Kerry Ross with College Football Game Day. Scores, features, highlights as we look ahead. The Cornhuskers and the Buffaloes at 4 o'clock Eastern Time next Saturday afternoon. And next Saturday night, Kevin and I will have that big rivalry in Georgia. The Yellow Jackets and the Bulldogs, 7:30.
Excuse me, I'm done that with Jim. That's a great game. Enjoy that. Always enjoy going there. In Atlanta, you should have a heck of a time doing that game, even though Georgia Tech's down. It's going to be shit.
It's like a honeymoon for you and I. Three games in 8 days.
Yeah.
Pitch back to Green. He's been the workhorse the last four. Gamecock possession stays on his feet. Penalty flag is down, and so is Harold at the 27-yard line. What a job Joe Morrison has done getting his Gamecocks ready for this. Brewster might have grabbed the face mask, or it might have been a chop block against Carolina. Out of Lima, Ohio, Joe Morrison. We talked about his great career in the National Football League. 14 years with the Giants. How many positions? He was like you. He played quarterback, halfback, wing back.
Played eight positions. His favorite was tight end. He was a defensive back. He liked tight end. He was a great receiver. I grew up in New York and watched him for many years. Said it helped him preparing and understanding his players and the problems they went through with the different positions. He's been successful everywhere he's been, Jim, so I guess it helped him.
And he only missed, Kevin, in 14 years in the National Football League. How many games? Eight.
Yeah, he played hurt. I remember. He came from an era where weightlifting and size was not as important as it is today. And he said to us that he felt that had he played today, he would not have been a pro. He could not have been a pro.
First and 19 after the penalty. Little delay up near the 15-yard line goes Harold Green. Well, we talked about Thanksgiving, and it's going to be a great game here on ESPN because both the Longhorns, Kevin, and the Aggies won today. So the winner of that game goes and sees the Hoss at the Cotton Bowl.
David McWilliams back at Texas, took over a program that was down and has turned it around. If they win that game and they go to the Cotton Bowl, he should be considered certainly for the Southwest Conference Coach of the Year and maybe a National Coach of the Year. That program they felt was 2-3 years away from being rebuilt. While they've lost some games, to get to the Cotton Bowl would be a momentous achievement. But he's got Jackie Sherrill standing in his way, and Jackie's been in a few Cotton Bowls in his day.
Tigers must feel like that. The noose is closing in. 2:01 left to go.
Here's Jim and Kevin at Williams Price.
Now, we've got another game coming up, Tim, as you know, Air Force in Hawaii, but we will have live cut-ins on that Syracuse game against West Virginia. A little delay, not much doing. Up across the 21 goes Keith Bing. Oh, we have a second. Congratulations to Mike Archer down at LSU. First year as the head coach of the Tigers. What a terrific job he's done with the program down there.
And maybe we ought to clear up that Southeast Conference race. If Auburn beats Alabama, they go to the Sugar Bowl. If Alabama wins the game, from what I understand, LSU will go to the Sugar Bowl. The agreement is that Syracuse will play the highest-ranked team at the time the season ends, the conference season.
1:20 when the ball is snapped, 3rd and 10. Otherwise, a punting situation. They'll try to chop Harold Green down. They do at the 25. Let's see if Clemson takes a timeout. 1:12, 1:11, 1:10. Danny Ford, an assistant at Alabama under Bear Bryant, then an assistant at Virginia Tech, an assistant at Clemson, and then the head coach. He's been the head coach for 9 years. Green now, 27 carries, 106 yards. 45 seconds left. Gamecocks will let all the time expire. Are you surprised that Clemson didn't take a timeout? They've got the return on. Beautiful kick. Lot at the 33. Doesn't have any blockers now. Where's it going? A loss of 7 on the return. After a 41-yard punt, and Shed Diggs, who's been brilliant on specialty teams on the tackle.
And played extremely well as a starting defensive end. Tough night for Danny Ford, but hats off, really, to the South Carolina coaching staff and the preparations for this game. Absolutely remarkable. Beating a very, very good Clemson team tonight.
Frank Sadler, the offensive coordinator for the Gamecocks. It was Joe Morrison who wanted to take that veer offense and change it. He put in the 50 defense and the run-and-shoot offense. Williams will have to throw in a country mile. Side to run and pull it back down. Gets out of bounds at the 32 to stop the clock with 20 seconds left. This a rivalry that began in 1896. South Carolina won the first game here at Columbia by a score of 12-6. All the games were played here in Columbia until 1960. And now they alternate even years and odd years. It used to be called Big Thursday and was played the week of the State Fair. This game with lots of tradition and lots of emotion. Williams over the middle somehow finds Gary Cooper, and he is chopped down at the 48-yard line with 12 seconds left. Kevin, that's what you've been saying they should have been throwing all night.
Well, again, a wide receiver, and South Carolina really giving him that pattern, that hook inside, because they want to keep him in bounds and run the clock down. At this point, he could have anything. anything up to 20 yards around the hash marks.
Anything in the middle of the field, and this game should be about over. Williams puts up a rainbow. It is caught and then dropped at the 10-yard line. And that'll do it.
In this game was the South Carolina defense and the Clemson defense. They only gave up a touchdown apiece, but of course the field goal kicking by Mackey early in the game getting South Carolina close, and then a tremendous effort by the South Carolina Gamecock defense. A great game plan. The inability of the Clemson offense to run, and then because maybe of personnel problems, lack of receivers, they were not able to get their passing game going, and that really was the difference in the game. My hat off to the Gamecocks, beating a tough interstate rival.
You better get your jeans on now to get out of here. This town will be a party town tonight. Back with more after this timeout. Tonight's Hartford player of the game, Colin Mackey, a career best 49-yard field goal, another from 45. It was 7-6 at the half. The Gamecocks were on the short end. But our final score, the Gators. The Gamecocks 20. The Clemson Tigers 7. Don't forget, on Thanksgiving, a special presentation of CFA football. Kevin and I will be at the Texas A&M game, the Longhorns and the Aggies. Who'll go to the Cotton Bowl? You'll find out 8 o'clock Eastern time on Thanksgiving night. Coming up next, a big whack battle. They get off the bus throwing the football, Air Force and the Rainbow Warriors of Hawaii. Mackey from 49 and 45 made it 7-6 at halftime. And then two plays, 83 yards, the last one, 6 yards by Harold Green for the go-ahead touchdown. And the Gamecocks of South Carolina upset Clemson. For Kevin Kiley, I'm Jim Kelly. Good night. Let's go back to Tim.